Hi, Amanda Hartman, speech pathologist with AssistiveWare here. Have you just installed Proloquo2Go for the very first time? Maybe you're at this Get Started screen. I'm going to take you through the opening steps to set up Proloquo2Go for the first time. So let's go over to the iPad and get started. I know, I'm excited too. Let's go. From this first screen, tap Get Started. When you start Proloquo2Go for the first time, you have to make a couple of decisions. Let's set up Proloquo2Go as a new user. So I tap, I'm a new user, and then tap Next in the top right corner. I will tap Next through all these steps to create a Proloquo2Go user. Next, give the user a name. Today, I'll choose my name, Amanda. Then tap Next. Then I can choose my language preferences. I'm in Australia, so I select language and it has English Australia chosen. But you should go ahead and choose the language and region for where you are. If you wish to create a bilingual user, you would add another language here. You can see Proloquo2Go comes in Dutch, French and Spanish. Today, I will just create an English user. So I will close this and then tap Next. Now is a fun decision. What voice will Proloquo2Go use when it speaks out loud? There are lots to choose from. You can tap them to listen to them.
Hello, I am Amy.
This is a great chance to involve the person who will be using Proloquo2Go. Sit and listen to the different voices together.
Hello. Hi.
Let them choose the voice that suits them. There are many different voices to choose from. Children, teenagers, and adults.
Hi.
I'm in Australia, so I'm going to choose Lisa.
Hi.
Then tap Next. Now we can choose a grid size. The grid size is how many buttons we will have on the page. We can tap the plus and the minus buttons to see different grid sizes. So you can tap the plus, up, up, so it adds more buttons to the page and the buttons get smaller. Or you can tap the minus button to go down and down. There are fewer buttons on the page and the buttons will be bigger. As a general rule of thumb, we should choose the grid size based on what the person can see and touch. If I have seen someone navigate to their favorite app on an iPhone screen, then I know that they can see and touch smaller buttons. Today, I'm going to tap plus to the recommended grid size of 7x11. This adds 77 buttons to a page and gives me a great selection of words. With all these words, I will be able to say a lot. Now, tap next. Now I choose a skin tone. This will set the default skin color of the people symbols used in Proloquo2Go. Then next. To help us improve our products, you can see that we collect anonymous information. So this gives me an opportunity to give my consent. So I will agree and continue. Right. My user for Amanda has been made. I tap finish and it will take a few moments to create the new Amanda user and then another minute to download the voice I chose. Great, my voice is downloaded and we can start using Proloquo2Go. This is exciting. I can see so many words and so many opportunities to say what I think.
I like this.
I can tap the buttons and the words are spoken out loud and they go into this top message window.
I like this.
To even make a sentence. Let's look around the rest of the app. Along the top here, we have the message window where my words go, and there's this button here can be used to delete or clear.
I like this.
This top toolbar has the name of the page where I'm on, but it also has a share button so I can share things that have been written into my message window. Next is this grid filled with my 77 buttons. Many of these words are core words. Core words are the building blocks of language, and I can combine these different words to say lots of different things. The different types of words here are different colors, actually. For example, I can see lots of these pink words here. They are verb or action words. Now, these buttons along the bottom with the little tab on them, they're actually called folders. When I tap on these, it takes me to another page, a page filled with even more words, like here is my food page. Now, this has some good food words, but definitely we'll have to learn how to add some of my own favorite foods here. And lastly, let's look at that bottom toolbar. First, on the left is the tools pop-up. This has lots of important functions in here. Next is the keyboard, which takes me to an alphabet. Then in the middle is my home button. And when I tap that, it takes me back to the home page when I'm in a different folder. Next is the edit pencil. I click here when I want to edit and add things to my Proloquo2Go. And last is the options, or it's like the cog or the gear. This has all the background settings for the app. So what's my top tip to get started? Honestly, I just want you to start exploring. Explore the words, explore in your free time when you don't have any time or person demands. Open and close the folders.
Party.
Tap the words. Listen to how they sound.
Go.
Get yourself familiar with Proloquo2Go. And even start exploring it with your person that's going to be using Proloquo2Go too. You'll be learning it together. And you'll probably make mistakes together, but that's fine. As you're exploring the words, you tap the buttons to talk about what you were seeing, thinking and doing. Oh,
get.
I need to get some more.
We
are finished.
Finished.
Oh, I can see you are laughing.
I think
you like this. You are feeling happy.
Happy.
You are showing where buttons are and pointing to them as you speak. Showing what they mean and how they can be used to communicate real messages in real situations. We call this modeling. We know that someone needs to see us using Proloquo2Go to learn how to use it themselves. Of course, they can explore and play with it like we do, but they also need to see us finding and using words in the app. So, make a start today, and please reach out to us if you need any help. Thank you.